Hey everyone, and welcome back to Super Mario Advance 4. In this video, we're going to go through all of World 5. Now, this world is actually pretty lengthy. We have this part right here, and then the sky part. So there's actually a lot of levels to go through in this world, but it's just all going to be one video. I know I've debated between splitting up some of the worlds throughout the playthrough, but I'm just going to make this one long video. Anyway, this is 5-1, and I'm going to try to do something here that I usually don't bother with. The main thing you want to do here is just avoid... Well, you want to avoid getting hit, but you want to avoid the question blocks, too. There's actually two new enemies that we haven't seen yet in the playthrough. There's... you know, I can't remember their names. There's the beetles that you can actually step on. They're not like the buzzy beetles. And then they have the baby piranha planes. Okay, so let's go all the way down here. You want to get rid of this thing and grab this. Okay, so I actually did it. I was kind of worried that I wouldn't be able to do it. This is totally optional. You don't have to do this, but I did want to show it. The only thing, it's going to skip the most of the level, but there's not much here. I mean, there's a lot of piranha plants, a lot of those beetles. Pretty much the enemies that we've seen, there's a lot of them here. Alright, this is like a secret area. Okay, actually, if you go in that pipe... Oh wait, hang on, I messed that up. If you go in that pipe, you go to like... Well, you know what? No, I'll just show that part. If you fly up here, but you have to duck down to do it. If you fly over here and go right, you get a music box. There's a treasure chest with a music box in it. Those are useless to me, so I'm just going to show this part. Actually, this is much better. Get some 1-ups here. Okay, so this is under where we were before. I definitely don't want to get hit by that. You can swim over here if you want. There's actually another exit here, too. If you don't want to bother with like the star thing that I was doing, you can just use a P-Wing, but it's kind of a waste to me. And then if you go down here, there's a number 3. Oh, and this. So I guess Super Mario Bros. 3 and Super Mario Advance 4. That 4 is obviously not there in the original NES version, or the Super Nintendo one for that matter. Ah, the star respawned. Oh! Just not in time. Okay, but yeah, even though there's a lot of levels in this world, some of them are pretty short. So that's why I'm just thinking of making this one video. And we have an end spade game here. Oh. Yeah, no wonder I didn't do much in this one. I'm just not familiar with this table. Oops. Oh, we can try again another time. That's going to show up, you know, at least one or two more times. Okay, so here we are at 5-2. And you can actually skip most of this world if you hold right and time your fall so that you land on that note block and just go up in that pipe. But then you'll skip most of the level. And I do kind of want to show this, so... Okay. There's one lone green cheep down here. Okay, this is the deal with this level. Those beetles, they'll pretty much try to throw these blocks at you. And you want to try to get them before they get them, so you can, you know, throw them at them. Ah, I thought there was a mushroom there. Those blocks, they do disappear, though. If you notice, that one I was holding, it started fading a little bit. It wasn't flashing. That's when it's about to disappear. You don't want to get caught with that in your hand as it's disappearing, because the beetles will attack you. Okay, so we got through the first two levels. Those are on the easier side, but... once we get up to the sky part in this world... Oh, by the way, all of these are Tanuki suits. So, you know, you can pick whatever one you want. Anyway, once we get up to the sky, that's where the difficult levels happen, especially... There's some auto-scrolling levels that I have trouble with. I guess we'll go to 3. I have a lot of fire flowers, so let's just use one of those. Oh, okay. So this level is one of my favorite levels in the game. This one, yeah, if you've played Super Mario Bros. 3, you probably know which one this is. Where are you? Yes, anyway, this is the level with the Goomba shoe. This is a special item that you can get, and you can actually ride in the shoe and attack enemies that you normally couldn't. And this is pretty awesome. You can take other shoes too. And it's actually really cool, if you have a fire flower, you can actually fire with the shoe on. Yeah, you can even step on these guys, and these guys are normally invincible. Oh, I mean, well, you know, they still are, but they hurt you. And you can safely cross those with the shoe. That's why I really love this item. Unfortunately, if I remember right, this is the only level where you actually get this. You know, not counting World E, because I haven't played those levels yet, but I'm sure there's a few levels, at least a few levels, that have a shoe in it. Or, you know, at least one. Huh? I do want to try to keep this throughout the level. You know, the thing is, obviously once we finish the level, then we're not going to have the shoe anymore. It's something you don't keep with you. Oh, I tried to hop as fast as I could. Yep, sadly it's over. No more shoe. But yeah, that's a fun level. I like that level. Okay, we have Hammer Brothers here. I have a Fire Flower, so this is really easy. We have a star. That might be kind of useful in a level that's coming up soon. Okay, this one, I don't remember what you get from it, but it might be another music box. Oh no, it's a P-Wing. Okay, that's cool. I mean, I don't know how often I'm gonna use those in this playthrough, but, you know, they're nice to have just in case. Now, this is probably going to revert back to a spade, because I don't think I'm getting this leaf. Oh, that's a mushroom. Yep. No, oh, I could have swore I timed it on the mushroom. Yeah. That would have been nice if I did get that. The only thing is, I don't know if you have to get the leaf or you just have to win, but I'll look that up some other time. Now, there is something here I was going to use a P-Wing for. You might be able to get up there without it. I've never tried it. It's just kind of hard because there's so many enemies here. But there's... Yeah, there's a thing right here. You can go up in that pipe, but... You know, I think you would have to fly. But I think even if you didn't have a P-Wing, you just had the raccoon tail or the Tanuki suit, it'd be hard to get up there. I don't know if... Well, you might be able to. I don't know. It probably just skips most of the level, so it's probably not as important. But this level is actually kind of dangerous because there's so many thwomps here, and then I can't remember what these are called. I used to think they were disco balls when I was a kid, but yeah, those things, they're just everywhere here. Oh, and there's boos here too, I forgot about them. I thought that was a safe spot. Ooh. Oh, this one's tricky. You gotta, like, move forward a little bit to, like, lure him down. Oh, see, that's what I was trying not to do, but ended up happening anyway. You know what? Let's, I do kind of want to use a P-Wing here. I mean, I'm not using them anyway, plus my inventory looks full, so... Let's find out what's up there, because I've been up here before, but I don't know what's there. It's been a while. Like I said, it's probably a shortcut, or it's like some bonuses or something. Go up, okay. Oh, it's just a one-up. Well, that made up for the one I lost. It's like a couple minutes ago. Okay, actually, that even... Yeah, that's not even much of a shortcut. Because we actually saw that pipe earlier. Oh, now I'm stuck with this P-Wing. See, it's not always ideal to have this. I mean, for this part it is. This part is so easy with this. Ah, it's too easy, honestly. Oh, whoa. Yeah, I actually got towards the end. That was pretty much it right there. Oh, I was hoping it was like the flying variety. Anyway, after you use a P-Wing in one level, once you get to the map screen, you turn into a regular Raccoon Mario. Okay, so that bridge is there just in case I die, but 71 lives, that's not happening. Alright, so we cleared all the land levels here. This one here, I don't remember what the level name is called, I'll just call it a tower for now. This is the transitional level between the land and the sky section of World 5. So you do have to beat this in order to get to the sky part. It's not too bad, I mean, these things again, they're everywhere. And, you know, of course we saw a lot of these in the previous level too. Okay. Yeah, watch out for the Micro Goombas hiding here. Okay, another swamp, another sphere thing. Eventually, we're going to go back outside. Actually, I think right here. But if you notice, we're going up and up. So, eventually, we go high enough to go into the clouds. Okay, and here we go. Okay, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 levels here, including the airship and the fortress. So yeah, like I said, this world is pretty lengthy. And this level here. So we've seen these before. We haven't seen, this variety of these. I don't know what these are, but these red things. We've seen them before. I think in World 3 was the first time we saw them. There are varieties here that just don't stop spinning, and they're kind of scary. And then, you know, there's ones here that don't spin at all. The ones we've seen are like that one right there. Just, they spin, stop, spin, stop. That's it though. That level's really easy if you have the raccoon tail or the tanuki suit. Of course the P-Wing, because you can float. If you don't have that, then it's a lot more difficult. Because you have to use those scary platforms. You know, I forgot everything I did so far, so this is probably not going to last long. 10. Yeah, I went through like a couple levels and then I just forgot. Okay, this one here, there's something optional you can do here too. I'm going to try to do it. I mean, if not, I'm not too worried about it because the bonus you get, it's not really that important. But you do need to break this. If you don't have a raccoon tail, you can use a Koopa shell to break those blocks. Alright, you get a free tanuki suit here, which will help a little bit. But the thing I'm doing here is collecting all the coins in this level. Oh, shoot. Oh no, I lost it! I really didn't want that to happen either. Okay, but you want to collect all the coins in the level. Again, this is totally optional. And that landed on my head. See, I was trying to stomp on him so he would leave me alone for this part. Let's use a mushroom. Oh wait, do I have it? I have one. I didn't really want to waste all these, but you know, earlier I did say that this level, I mean not this level, this world would have some difficult levels. Well, for me, you know. Okay, so again, you want to try to get all the coins in this level. The part I was at, I think those were the rest of the coins. There's like one hidden here. Oh, I don't want that. Okay, I'm going to try to lure him over here. I didn't think he was going to fire that up. Okay, maybe if he's all the way over there, he'll leave me alone. But knowing that thing, probably not. Yep, he's right there. Okay, I'm going to wait. And this respawned. Get out of here, man. Okay, oh! I think those were all the coins, so... Oh wait, I think there's a power-up. Yep. Alright, so if I did this right, I don't know if I forgot any coins. Hopefully I didn't, but I think those were all of them. Oh, maybe I did forget something. Or maybe you only have one chance at it or something. But what happens is, if you get all the coins in that level, I think there's 28 of them, something like that, a white mushroom house shows up and you get a P-Wing. So, you know, it would have been nice to have, but at the same time, I'm not going to use a lot of those. Come on. I think I did it. Yes. Okay, well, that's probably not going to happen again in the playthrough. Okay. 5-6. I am not a huge fan of this level. I'm probably going to die a few times here. When I was a kid, I used to skip this level a lot. Like, you know, as you saw there, it's totally optional. You can actually go to 7 and skip 6 completely. Or, you know, I would use a P-Wing here. This level is kind of tough without, you know, a tail. Or the Tanuki suit. But yeah, there's a level just like this in New Super Mario Bros. Wii. Except they have, like, the larger Parabeetles, which I think that was the game they were introduced in. Oh, I want that. Okay, this part is a little bit easier if you hit that P-switch. Oh, okay, I did it. Cool. Yeah, the thing about that level, it's pretty short. Okay, so you saw how there was a Lakitu at the end there. Just, I think he might have shown up in a different level too. Just expect him to show up in a lot of these levels at the very end. Wait, I don't remember... Oh, yeah. We've seen these everywhere, the Micro Goombas here. Okay, oh, you know... I'm actually gonna take an alternate path. Oof. If you go down here... Okay, I was trying to get a power-up. But I'm just gonna go in. I don't know if the one I missed there was a power-up or not, but... That's okay. Okay, there's that. The only thing is, where is... I thought there was... like a leaf here or something. Because that's how I got out before. Oh, there we go. I guess you can't go in there with the star. Oh. But yeah, if you have the leaf, you can actually pretty much bypass this whole part. I tried to outrun that, but... Anyway, you can actually fly over this section there and get to the end. I'll just use this. But I actually was almost at the end until I got killed by that spiny. You know, that was me being reckless. I was trying to outrun that. Yeah, let me see if I could show that part. Because I needed a leaf, but I couldn't really show it if I didn't have one. There we go. Okay. See if I can do this. Okay. Yeah, just keep going all the way to the right and just fly over this. This is what I was talking about. And you're at the exit. Thanks a lot, Locke, too. I guess he was following me. I didn't see him on screen, but... yeah, whatever. We're done with that level. I kind of accidentally showed the two paths that you can take. Oops. Okay, well, a mushroom, you know, that's nice. Because, you know, if I don't want to waste a fire flower or something. Okay, here is the... oh. Yep, I knew it. This... The beginning there is, like, so troll-like because if you fall off, then you're dead. Obviously, because there's just lava everywhere. I'll try it without a power-up. I don't want to waste it. Okay. The only thing is, the part after this, yeah, there's lava everywhere, and there's these lava bubbles just going up and down. Some are coming from the ceiling. I was really hoping that wouldn't happen either. When I was playing off recording, that happened, Oh no! That happened at least 3 or 4 times. I was like, oh, I hope that doesn't happen in the recording, and it definitely did. Oh! I forgot about that one. I thought it was home free, too, because the, part with Boom Boom's actually not far from where I died. I'm not gonna waste that. Oh! Okay. Now this is becoming annoying. Yeah, I don't want to waste the power-up if I'm just going to lose it if I fall off. Okay, yeah, I don't know. Maybe because I'm small Mario, it's easier for me to manage. I have no idea, but... okay, I didn't die that time. Yeah, I'm going to go around because this dry bones kind of makes me nervous. And that's going backwards, too. I don't want that to happen, because it's wasting, you know, some time. This time I remember that. And I feel like I could keep that star going if I didn't waste all that time trying to, like, track it down. Have to be careful here. Okay, I made it to Boom Boom, and I'm Super Mario, so that's good. That's another thing you have to watch out for, that gap. This room is actually cool. I mean, you find Boom Boom in a room surrounded by lava. Alright, he tried to fly too. Nope. Whew, okay. Bit of a tough one there for me, but... as you saw there, it's actually a pretty short fortress as well. Okay, I'll... try the end spade. I don't remember anything I've done, except for I think there's a flower there. It's a mushroom. I know I've seen that before, I don't remember where it is. Wait, I've seen that 20 coin. Oh, it's... You know, I'm gonna just forget where all those things were. Alright, let's see if I can get this leaf. Oh... I swear I hit it on the... I don't know. I want to see what's after that. I mean, it's probably like... wait, so it goes from spade to heart, so it's probably like diamond or something. Wait, what level is this again? Is this the Lakitu one? Yes. So that's the main thing with this one. Lakitu is just... following you throughout the whole level. I mean, we... oh. Ah. Yeah, I got to the end too. I was trying to get there without getting hit. I think, yeah, there's another one here. Well, you know, I was running the whole time. Actually, I think if you run the whole time, it's a little bit better. You just have to kind of watch out for all those enemies and stuff. Okay, we're almost at the end. We have this to go through, the Hammer Brothers battle, and oh. I don't like this level either. So, it's auto-scrolling and there's a bunch of these platforms. If it was just the platforms and the auto-scrolling, it wouldn't be that bad, but there's two enemies that show up here. And they make things a little bit more difficult. Where are you? I know it's coming up soon, the first one. There. Yeah, you know, I don't know if it's safer to just avoid him for now, or... Okay, well, that works. Whoa. Okay, I was gonna show the self-destruct thing that it does, but I'd rather not get hit there. Okay, and that's it. So we've gone through all the regular levels, we just have some Hammer Brothers to fight, and then the airship. Okay, that went much better than last time. And it was for an item that I don't care about. Okay, now it's time for the airship. And the king here in this land has been transformed into an Albatross from Super Mario Bros. 2. Okay, the thing about this airship, it's kind of interesting because there's no enemies, like no rocky wrenches or anything like that. It's just all cannons and flamethrowers, which, you know, we've seen airships like this before, but these are, they're more numerous here than in past ones. Okay, I want to try to keep this fire flower, not because it's useful here, because like I said, there's no enemies, but for that extra hit. Because the boss here is Roy Koopa, and I mean, I've mentioned this before, he's not too different from his siblings, but the main thing is he can cause earthquakes, which is kind of scary. Oh. Okay, the thing that usually messes me up here is that. And unfortunately, unfortunately there's no extra item here from what I remember, so I'm going to be fighting Roy as Super Mario. Yeah, there's nothing hidden. Okay, you just want to try to jump when he does the earthquake. Okay, yeah, that wasn't that bad. Oof. Yeah, that's the main thing that'll save you. Because if you get stunned from his earthquake, then he has like a free hit on you. So him and Ludwig do that. But we're not going to see Ludwig till World 7. Okay, the king is back to normal, and we're done with World 5. It's, you know, even though there's some levels I hate in it, it's not, you know, unfun. It's actually pretty cool for the most part. Oh, she actually had a note about the next world, because the next one is the ice-themed one. Okay, well that is the end of World 5. In the next video, we're going to get started with World 6, and there's some pretty fun ones in this one. There's also some tough ones here too, just because the ice and stuff like that. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time for more Super Mario Advance 4. Thank you.